Hey guys, it's Chris. When you think about the value of an item, you likely think about something high class and truly valuable. But sometimes it's the odd or weird items that really get the prices up. Join me as I reveal to you 10 creepy items that are really expensive. Number 10, John Lennon's molar. The Beatles are one of the greatest bands in the history of music, and many of their items are worth a pretty penny. People will pay hundreds of thousands, sometimes even millions, for original records. Their outfits, memorabilia, all sorts of things. But for John Lennon, you know, Yoko Ono and Give Peace a Chance John Lennon, he had an item worth a lot that you might not expect. His molar. For the record, this wasn't a crazy fan attack gone wrong story. Rather, it was a story of greed from Lennon's housekeeper. You see, Lennon had hired a dentist to pull out a molar because it was just hurting him. He kept the tooth, but then gave it to his housekeeper to throw away. It was kind of gross. But before she did, he instead stated that she should give it to her daughter, who was a major fan of the Beatles. Which is even grosser. Oh, I see you're a fan. Well, here, have my molar. How much do you guys think my molar would be worth? Instead, the housekeeper decided to keep the tooth for herself, and get this, then she actually sold it to a dentist for $32,000 30 years later. That dentist gave the tooth, or a fragment of it apparently, to his sister, Kristen Zuck, who's an artist. She made a clay sculpture of Lennon and put the tooth in it, as she was working on it, preparing for an art show in August. Zuck said, "This is like a time capsule. It will contain his DNA." She's using the sculpture to promote the charity Smile Train, which helps provide cleft palate surgery for children living in poverty. Number 9, the Anguished Man. It shouldn't be too much of a surprise to know that certain creepy items are believed to be haunted, such as the case with the painting known as the Anguished Man. The painting was said to have come from an artist who was rather disturbed, so much so that he used his own blood mixed into the paint. That can't be good for everyone. Please don't try this at home. I don't think your painting will come out better if you do this. According to a man named Sean Robinson, his grandmother had gotten a hold of the painting and kept it in her attic for over 25 years. During that time, her house was constantly besieged by paranormal activity. Events she claimed to have experienced were crying sounds, odd noises in the house, and even seeing the dark figure of a man in her home. After his grandmother died, the painting went to Sean, and no sooner did he put it in his basement than he, too, started to hear odd things in his house, just like his grandmother. While it was said to be on sale for £1,500, it is considered so valuable and so haunted that it's no longer for sale. So you're out of luck. And now for number 8, but first, what's the creepiest thing you have in your house? Let us all know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. And here it is, number 8. Marilyn Monroe's chest x-ray. When it comes to beauty icons of time and history, few match up to the beauty that was Marilyn Monroe. This stunning blonde wasn't born to fame, but she became timeless no matter what happened to her. The actress and model wooed millions with her looks, and many men went to great lengths just to try and be close to her when she was alive. Someone was so desperate to get a piece of Marilyn that they apparently found a guy who had a chest x-ray of Marilyn in 1954. Many of you are probably asking, why would somebody want a chest x-ray? But when it comes to fans, they'll take whatever they can get. So an x-ray? I mean, I guess why not? And how much was it worth? $45,000. You almost have to wonder if Norma Jean or Marilyn would be amazed or disturbed by that number. Creepy, yes. Expensive for some people, but I guess the question is, how much of a fan are you? Fun fact, one of the most famous scenes in Monroe's life, the white dress scene in 7 Year Itch, was sold for much more than that. The dress was bought for $4.6 million in 2011. Quite a lot for a dress from Marilyn, but hey, that thing is part of pop culture. The chest x-ray, eh, not so much. Number 7. Scarlett Johansson. Scarlett Johansson is one of the highest paid actresses in the world today. Her upcoming solo film as Black Widow from the Marvel Cinematic Universe is one that has been requested for a very long time, and she's getting paid $20 million just to do it. She's worth a lot, and apparently, so is her tissue. During an appearance on The Tonight Show, she had to blow her nose and was given a tissue to do just that. Later on, Johansson decided to try and sell the tissue, because I guess why not? And she got $5,000 for it. There's a lot that can be said here, including some questionable morality on the part of Johansson. However, in a lovely twist, Johansson noted that the money raised from the auctioning of the tissue wouldn't be given to her, but rather the USA Harvest Charity. A worthy end to the whole endeavor. Still, it's pretty creepy that someone would buy something like that, right? I guess it's a good conversation piece. Oh, this Kleenex? Yeah, Scarlett Johansson blew her nose in it. But then I guess how are you supposed to prove that? How much do you think your used tissue would be worth? Number 6. The soul-possessed doll. eBay is a place where you can find truly anything if you're willing to look hard enough. So if you're looking for a doll that's possessed by the soul of a lost woman, well, you know where to go. Sure enough, there is one, or at least there was one. A doll like that was being offered on the site. According to the owner, the doll had the soul of a woman inside her, both of whom are called Diana. So why would you want a possessed doll? Well, the seller claimed that the doll is a surefire way to cause paranormal activity. Previous events caused by the doll include sightings of phantom children as well as swing sets moving on their own. That's so creepy. Pretty spooky, but the owner is also clever to note that the doll doesn't work the same for everyone. She also apparently has issues with certain beauty products, so you should be careful about what you put on her in case you want to start brushing her hair. The doll itself cost $1,250. I'm going to pass on this one, but let me know if you decide to get one for yourself. Number 5. Gary Coleman sweats. Gary Coleman is very much a cautionary tale about what happens when fame doesn't last. He was a star on Different Strokes, but then had numerous money issues, and because of this, he had to try and sell off things to try and make ends meet, including putting up a set of Gap Kids sweats that he wore for the show once. The true weird part of this one is that allegedly only made $500, and that was because of late night host Jimmy Kimmel. There was also apparently a bid for the sweatpants at $400,000, and that was later revealed to be a fraud, and potentially even Coleman himself to try and jack up the price. Still, it's a little creepy how this whole thing came about, and $500 for old sweatpants and then false bids, the whole thing's just super shady. Number 4. Toast. Toast is one of the easiest things to make, no doubt. You take bread, you stick it in the toaster, voila, you're done. You've got toast. But apparently, some people will pay a lot of money for toast if it's been eaten by a celebrity. No, this isn't a joke or a prank. This actually happened. One of the first cases of this was with Justin Timberlake when he was with the band NSYNC. He would not eat all of his toast, and so he decided to sell it one day and got $3,000 for it. To outdo that, you need only look at the band One Direction, another boy band that skyrocketed to popularity. Singer Niall Horan also had a thing for toast, and one day he decided to sell his own half-eaten toast. The person bought it for a staggering $100,000. If you put those two together and then calculated how much bread you could buy to make a complete piece of toast, I mean, it'd be a lot of bread, which makes this purchase both creepy and wasteful. Who wants half a piece of chewed toast? Never mind, it's fine. I guess there's no judgment here. Number 3. Ed Gein's pot. If you're not familiar with the name Ed Gein, that's okay, but you're likely to know the things he inspired. You see, he was a serial killer. During the 1950s, he would go on a reign of terror that would end up with people getting killed, skinned, and turned into various other objects that Gein would enjoy, such as furniture and being made into clothes. This is so creepy. To do some of these acts, Gein had a pot that he would use, I guess to like boil stuff, and that pot is actually a key part of his legacy. So I guess what's his legacy? Well, he was the basis of some films, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre and The Silence of the Lambs, both of which are horror films. As for the pot, it was a real thing, and a paranormal expert from the show Ghost Adventurers bought it for $2,800. What he uses it for is unclear, but the previous owner used it as a flower pot. So weird. Number 2. Andy Warhol's wig. Pop art icon Andy Warhol drew many wonderful things during his career, but one thing he couldn't fix with his art was his receding hairline. So because of that, he had to wear a variety of wigs to help cover up what was going on with his head. This actually gave him the iconic look that he is most associated with. In 2011, one of those wigs actually went up for sale, and it sold for over $10,000. As creepy as that is on its own, there was actually tape on the wig that was being used by Warhol to keep it on his head. So you literally have a piece of him on the piece that was on him. Number 1. Black Orlov Diamond. There are many jewelry items in the world today that are expensive for one reason or another, but few of them are dubbed as cursed. Many of you likely know the story of the Hope Diamond, but there is another cursed diamond that's expensive as well. The Black Orlov Diamond. Not unlike the Hope Diamond, the Black Orlov Diamond is one that was stolen in India via a statue of the creator god of the Hindu religion Brahma, or so the legend goes at least. After it was stolen, a series of odd events happened to the owners of it. Specifically, they all committed suicide, and it's still unclear as to why they actually did that. Due to the publicity of these deaths, the diamond was considered cursed. But unlike the Hope Diamond, this was one curse that apparently got broken, for the diamond itself was taken from its original form and reshaped into a more stylish necklace. Since that point, no one has died while wearing it, including actress Felicity Huffman, who actually wore it to the Oscars in 2006. And as of this taping, she's still alive, guys. The value of the Black Orlov Diamond is actually a bit in flux. The last time it was sold, it went for $352,000, but that was in 2006. Many feel that it could be worth around $1 million today, if not more. Thanks for watching. What did you think of those creepy items? Can you believe that some of these sold for that much? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and if you've ever had a creepy item, and be sure to subscribe so I can see you next time.